Welcome to hear the first lecture on air quality, and this is the introduction. During this lesson, I will try to answer the questions on what is air quality and what are the sources that weaken the air quality. I will tell you a little bit about the road traffic emissions and WHO guidelines for air quality. So, let's get started. What is air quality? It is basically the quality of the air that you breathe. Air pollution can happen for many different reasons, and in the pollution process, the natural state of the atmosphere is changed. Polluted air is associated with health effects like increased mortality from strokes, heart disease, and acute respiratory infections, to mention few. Air quality can be weakened by pollutants from several sources, like motor vehicles, ships, aeroplanes, road traffic, and industrial facilities, forest fires, and stuffs in the home. Different kind of emission sources have their own characteristics in pollution compounds. It also depends on locations. Which sources of pollution are the most significant one at the site? It is very common that the road traffic has a significant effect on air quality in urban surroundings. Since the emissions of road traffic are released close from the breathing level, the most significant components from the road traffic exhaust gases are nitrogen oxides and fine particulate matter, if we consider only health and air quality. Both these compounds have many different kind of health effects, and for example, long-term exposure to them may cause asthma and reduce lung functioning. There is no safe limit for particulate matter concentrations, below which there are no health effects at all. WHO has given guidelines for air quality. Air pollution is an environmental risk to health, and by reducing the air pollution levels, countries can reduce the burden of many health effects significantly. The idea behind the air quality guideline values are that they should not be exceeded there where people live and stay. Particulate matter can contain different elements and compounds like sulfate, nitrates, ammonia, black carbon, and so on. And in general, fine particulate matter is defined to have a diameter of 2.5 microns or less, and it's called PM2.5. And while breathing, it can penetrate deep into the lungs, and some can even enter the blood system. In long-term exposure, they have many health effects. Guideline values for PM2.5 is 10 micrograms per cubic meter in annual level. The highest daily value shouldn't exceed 25 micrograms per cubic meter. WHO guidelines for nitrogen oxides, nitrogen dioxide, is 40 micrograms per cubic meter in annual level, and the highest 1 hour mean shouldn't exceed 200 micrograms per cubic meter. Nitrogen dioxide is a quite typical pollutant of anthropogenic combustion process. And by that I mean heating, power generation and engines in vehicles and ships. So thank you for listening to the first part of the lectures on air quality. See you during the next class.